Hello and welcome to People's Voice, where true stories touch deep emotions. Today, we delve into, I literally walked in on my wife cheating on me with her ex. Come, let's explore these real-life tales. Together almost 7 years, married for just over one. She dated him from ages 18 to 22, then someone else for a couple of years, then me from 2012 until now. We are 31, he's 40-ish. Long story short, we do everything together, including running a successful small business. Our friend group makes fun of how perfect our falling in love story is, and other than this problem, it has been a very happy, fun, successful relationship. Over the years, she saw him occasionally, birthdays, holidays, etc. maybe once every couple of months, always for an hour or two, dinner or coffee. I never, not once, saw him. He is married and has a child, and always hid from his wife that he was hanging out with my wife. No, he cheated on my wife several times while they were dating, so I have always been baffled why she wanted to keep in contact with him. He also was in a serious accident where she rehabilitated him, feeding him in bed for months, and then he cheated on her again as soon as he was back on his feet. He also made her clean his entire house all the time and inspected her work. She doesn't have many friends, so she always said it was nice to meet up with an old friend who shared history. Whatever, I didn't think much of it at first, and I trusted her even though I disagreed with her. So, one day, a couple of years in, I see her phone light up on the coffee table. He texted her. I glance, and it is a super sexual kind of joke. I freak out inside. I talk to her about it and say it is very inappropriate. Yuck, why she says she'll talk to him, and it will never happen again. I write it off as him being a dirtbag. A few months later, it happens again. Now I'm very freaking right out, so I start reading through her texts while she's asleep because, you know, as embarrassing and gross as it is, I need to know. Lots of sexual jokes or general remember the time texts, also texts being critical of me. I wake her up, screaming, saying she can never see him again if this continues. She doesn't see him for several months. Somehow, over the next year or so, she talks me into being okay with it again. His cat dies. We need real estate advice. He's in that line of work, so I don't know, whatever. I say okay because it's been like a year. This is around year 4 or 5. It seems fine and normal for a while, but I keep reading the texts because, gross, I find some more sleazy jokes. I snap and say, for real, this is the last time. Now, a year later, somehow, once again, I come around to allowing them to hang out, but I am not happy about it. I must add, I have been vehemently not happy about it and telling her so, and it is our sole problem, and it always comes up how much I hate him. But I love her, so I let her, and it's only every couple of months or so, so whatever. Anyway, flash forward to the last couple of months. I noticed they're talking way more often, lots of phone calls and texts. We have each other's locations because we are married, and she insisted. I never look, but now I start to look. I check a few weeks ago, and she's at an address I don't recognize. I call her to see what's up. She sounds odd, says she is at a friend's house. I know where this person lives, and it is not the location she is currently at. So, I say hello to X's name for me, assuming that's what she is doing. She rushes home. She is so scared that she was caught hanging out with him and in a lie. She is so scared she starts puking and doesn't sleep all night. I am mad as hell, but I forgive her. We are fine for a couple of weeks. She is still texting with him a lot. We work a lot all week together and have fun. He is around in her life enough over the years that I can't help thinking of him often and comparing myself to him. He is super rich, I'm definitely not. Thoughts of them pop into my mind, even while we are being intimate. I tell my mind to get lost, but it keeps happening. I am losing trust. After dropping her off at home after work, I go back to do more work, mentioning I'll be out until 2 a.m. or so. I get tired and come home early, thinking we could just watch Netflix. She isn't home even though I just spoke with her. I check her location, and she is nearby his house. The location updates, she is on her way home. I see the dots stop at the top of the street. I wait 10 or so minutes. I walk up our street, expecting to just surprise them, meet him for the first time, introduce myself very awkwardly, and then ask her why she is lying about seeing him. As I walk closer, I don't see two silhouettes. I get closer and find them in his car, but she's on his lap, kissing him, arms wrapped around him. I pause for a few seconds in shock. I open his door fast. I scream, punch him in the face. He looks scared and confused. I throw my ring onto his dash and scream some sort of speech. I storm away back home, grab clothes, and drive 2 hours north to stay at my dad's. I think of all the times they must have been together. How could it be possible that the only time I have ever seen his face, they are kissing, out of the dozens and dozens of times I have let them get together? It can't just be the one time, right? I come back to town. We talk. I yell and scream and break stuff, smash a chair, asking for the truth. She says she also kissed him when his cat died 4 years ago, but those were the only two times, and they were because she was trying to make him happy. My trust is shattered. I don't believe those could be the only two times after all the sexual joking texts. And I mean, we are adults. Who the only just makes out for a bit? Even if that is the truth, I have told her for years that he was trying to be more than a friend. She always just brushed it off and continued to convince me that they are just friends and it's no big deal, even though she knew I really didn't want her to see him. Even all of her friends and family have continuously scolded her for seeing him after what he did to her. Considering all that, and the fact that she cheated on me 4 years ago when his cat died, like how dare she? Anyway, I've read online that couples counseling and one-on-one counseling is the only way to get out of this alive. But to be honest, I'm not feeling very hopeful. This was a building problem over years, my only problem with her, and it exploded. I am not a violent person. I have been in one fight my entire life in grade 7, and now I have punched a man in the face. I just don't know if I believe her. She deleted him off everything and promised she will never see him again, but who knows how long that will last. I guess she just never got over him and just lied to herself, thinking it was just a friendship and would do anything to get that attention from him. Anyway, anybody else gone through this? What do I do? I hate that I'm posting this. I just don't want our friends to know. Thanks. Public reactions. User, MKR Foxdan says, "You are an absolute doormat." Her saying she only kissed him twice to make him feel better after his cat died and now? I honestly worry about you if you think that's anything but laughable. She's straight up cheating with him for a long time while they joke and make fun of you. Needless to say, you need to leave. I hope you have some options for dissolving your professional connection as well. Now is a good time to stop being a pushover. To be clear, this isn't just a case where you need to end it. You need to end it with extreme prejudice. I'm actually angry for you and at you for letting yourself be walked on so much. User, Sure Yukin says, "She's been lying. Trickle truthing. She is hooking up and sucking him. And you've been lying on your back with a welcome written on you. She doesn't like you, doesn't love you, doesn't respect you, but benefits from your naivete and, if I were a betting man, your chore play." User 03 Slampig says, "It's clear what you have to do. Leave her. No amount of therapy will get through to her. She has zero respect for you, and you have to learn the meaning of the word no. There's just some things you have to say no to. You need to leave immediately." User Mars Doom says, "Well, first of all, I'm really sorry you have to go through this. It sounds really awful, and I can only imagine what kind of emotions you have been processing. As much as you love her, it sounds like she continually disrespected you and had some kind of relationship with him. That trust is hard to build back. Me, personally, I'd probably just move on. I would have so much contempt for her lies and cheating. User, Biscuit Eater says, how many chances does she get? Do you want to spend the next 7 years wondering if she will be with him again today? She has carried on this emotional affair for so long she doesn't know how to go on without it. Even if you can get past this, I think you need to make her believe it is over so she will take you seriously. Tell her it is over and start divorce proceedings. She needs to hit rock bottom before you can build up trust again.
If you love this story and crave more tales of love, betrayal, and healing, don't forget to subscribe for more from Cheating Stories.